Welcome to this video series on MDS, which is a minimum data set required for CMS submissions for all nursing home residents. Today we'll be talking about CASPER, which is the Certification and Survey Provider Enhanced Report System that helps you know all kinds of interesting questions about your MDS data. Remember, with a database, when you ask a question, it's called a query. When you get an answer, it's called a report. For more information than this short video can give you, please go to the CASPER Reporting User's Manual on the www.cms.gov website. Welcome to today's session on CASPER reports. Many people think that the CASPER system is used for assuring that their assessment batch was received by CMS. They do this by watching their validation reports, and this is an important step every time a submission is exported. But CASPER can do so much more for you and your agency. By getting familiar with the variety of reports available, you can improve your business, enable your employees to work together to achieve goals, and concentrate on improving clinical results. The first thing to realize is that CASPER is an old system, written in old code and graphics. This means at least two things. Number one, when you first look at CASPER, you have to know what you are doing. Many options typically found on a more recent database home screens are not there. User interface options like copy, cut, paste, insert graph, format report, and back are absent or not user-friendly. It is up to you to know how to talk to CASPER and how to interpret the results. The second thing is that CASPER is fast and stable. When you run a query, it seldom takes more than a minute to get an answer. This is because it is old and does not spend a lot of processing time on the user. As we discussed a minute ago, by assuming that you know how to use the program, it doesn't spend time checking that you ask the question the right way and fixing your mistakes. So let's work on gaining confidence and getting the results you need. You are qualified to use CASPER if you have the user ID and passwords used by your company to submit batches of data. Your administrator decides if you are selected for this honor, not CASPER. CASPER does not care if you are a PhD or not. It does not ask if you are an RN or a CPA. It also means that you should have a backup person to help you run reports. The company's user ID and passwords should not be the sole property of any one person in case of emergencies. The only thing that CASPER asks of you is that you use Internet Explorer as your browser. If you routinely use Chrome or Mozilla or any other internet browser, your pointer will not land on the correct spot, or it may be hard to enter dates. This is what they mean by other operating systems may give unexpected results. You enter CASPER the same way you enter the assessment admission screen. As you enter your username and password, you are asked if you want to submit assessments or go to CASPER. When you click on Go to CASPER, you get a screen that looks something like this. Your screen may look different than mine because there are some options for color and background, but not many. The first thing to notice is the 8 buttons on the upper right. Especially notice folders, reports, and queue. Let's start with reports. Under this button, there are 2 boxes. The one on the left is a smaller box called Report Categories. This is a decision tree that has a little plus sign next to the folders. I probably have a lot more folders than you do because I have different permissions from the national administrators. If you click on a plus sign, the folder opens up to show possible reports on the larger right-hand side box. See how the name in the larger box, Oasis Quality Improvement, is the same as the name in one of the folders I opened up on the left-hand box. HHA Maintenance has Oasis Quality Improvement listed inside of it. Then, inside the Oasis Quality Improvement, it lists many possible reports, all in alphabetical order by report name. How many reports are there? Is this all there is? Well, no, because Oasis Quality Improvement is only one folder inside the HHA Maintenance folder. Also notice on the bottom of the larger box, it says pages 1, 2, and 3. That's another clue that there are other reports inside this folder that might be of interest to you. Once you have settled on a report that interests you, simply click on the report name underlined in black. You will get another screen with a long box labeled CASPER Report Submit that asks for options for running the report. The name of the report you selected is under that on the left-hand side. You might not have the option for facility ID because you only have permissions to get information from your facility. This report, a roster report, is a snapshot. It gives you information that is true from the database at the moment you ask for it. If there is information that you added last week and successfully submitted, it will be there. If there is information you intended to add but did not, it is not going to be there on this report. If there is information that you add next week, next week's report will show that new information. So very little customization of this report is possible, except running it again at a later date. But CASPER does not care. You can run the same report right away or wait till next month. But next month's report will give different results because there has been data added or subtracted. Some reports let you customize a date. If so, you get drop-down boxes with options of calendars to customize dates. Use the drop-down arrow to get to other frequently used time periods, or make up your own dates depending on your question. Other reports let you customize not just the time period, but a particular field. Other reports ask you to compare two time periods, one as prior and one as current. You can accept the default time period as the report options come up, like this example of year over year. Or you can customize it with very long or very short time periods. Still, other reports help you know how your facility is doing against state and national averages. You can accept these default time periods or change them to agree with each other. In this case, the begin and end dates are the same time period for analysis of your facility's data. The comparison group is the state and national data for that specific time period. Note that by default, these two time periods are the same. You are the only one who can decide if that is the information you want. In any case, once you have decided what report you want and customized to give you useful information, click on the Submit button. After doing that, the report request will be sent electronically to the ASAP database for your answer. You can look for it later, but if you are waiting for an answer now, you can verify for yourself that the request is received and the report is compiling for your use. Do this by going up to the top and clicking on the Queue button. You may get a screen that looks like this. This means that your status of your query is requested, which means that the ASAP database knows you want this information and they will get it to you soon. This screen also tells you on the left-hand side that they are processing 0 of 2, meaning that right now no one's report is actively running. It also tells you that the position you are in line is queue two of two, so you are second in line. It verifies the name of the report you asked to run, in this case, MDS 3.0 Facility Level Quality Measure Report. So you know it has received your report. The line is not long, and it will be ready soon. If your report takes more than 5 minutes to run, it is likely that there are unusual events on the national database side. Or pushing the queue button might say something like this. That says that the central ASAP database not only knows that the report is requested, but that they have already been working on it for 2 seconds. It should be ready very soon. To check, click on the refresh button on the lower right. Aha, that's what you want to see. This does not mean that the query is lost. Rather, it means that the report is finished. You are now through the line, and the report is waiting for you under the Folders button. It should be right on top, in page 1, listed as a .pdf file. You can verify that is the report you wanted by looking on the right-hand side for the date and timestamp in Eastern Time. By clicking on the file name, the resulting .pdf file can be pulled up and inspected, searched, and copied, printed, given the name and saved, or retained as it is on CASPER. With CASPER Report, practice makes perfect. Have fun practicing. Thank you for your interest in MDS and CASPER. If you need more information on this topic, please go to the CASPER Reporting User's Manual on the www.cms.gov website. Thank you for your time.